Greetings, everyone, and good afternoon, and welcome once again to the Baptist Bread Devotional and Scripture Song broadcast for this 22nd day of September. And today's topic is titled Curriculum. Amen. And so before we get started on that, I'd like to greet you as always in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world, and hope and pray that he's your Lord and Savior today. Amen. All right, so we're going to start with the scripture song for today, and then we'll get into today's topic. So if you're just joining, you can turn along with me to Psalms 43, verses 3 through 4. And we'll sing along with Brother Dean and Sister Patty.
Psalms 43, 3 and 4.
Oh, send out the light and thy truth. Let them lead me. Let them bring me unto thy holy hill and to thy tabernacles. Then will I go unto the altar of God, unto God my exceeding joy. Yea, upon the harp will I praise thee, O God, my God. Amen. Send out thy light and thy truth. Let them lead me, let them bring me to thy holy hill, to thy tabernacles. Then shall I go unto the altar of God, unto my exceeding joy. Yea, upon the harp will I praise thee, O God, my God. Send out thy light and thy truth. Let them lead me, let them bring me unto thy holy hill and to thy tabernacles. Then will I go unto the altar of God, unto God my exceeding joy. Yea, upon the harp will I praise thee, O God, my God. Yea, upon the harp will I praise thee, O God, my God. Amen. All right, so put that back to the beginning there and try that again towards the end of the broadcast. Amen. Now it's time to get into today's topic, and today's topic is titled Curriculum for this 22nd day of September. And we've got two passages here, Proverbs 22:6 and then Jeremiah 10:2a. So it says here in Proverbs 22:6, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. And then Jeremiah 10:2a says, thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen. Amen. So learn not the way of the heathen. And go read Jeremiah 10 on your own. And it talks about this tree that they fasten with nails and deck it with silver and gold. And you find out what that tree is representing, the Christmas tree and all that stuff. So but we won't get into that today because that doesn't seem to be what the topic's about. But anyway, I'll go and tell you the author here is GG. That was the initials for, I believe that's Guy Goodall. All right, so let me see here. GG, where is that? Yep, that's Guy Goodall, and he's the pastor of Bible Baptist Church in Hudson Falls, New York. All right, let me read you what he wrote here on this topic of curriculum. All right, he says here, the curriculum you choose for your child's education, well, maximize one of the two ways they can or will go. The way of the heathen is the foundation of the Status Schools, STATIST, the status schools, and that way may lead to intellectual, social, moral, and spiritual corruption. And it says Proverbs 2, 18 and 19. So let's go there and read that. Proverbs 2, 18 and 19. Nope, went too far there. All right, so Proverbs 2, 18 and 19. All right, so it says here, make sure that's right. All right, so it says here, the way, let me read that again. So the way of the heathen is the foundation of the status schools, and that way may lead to intellectual, social, moral, and spiritual corruption. And that's Proverbs 2, 18 and 19, so let me read that. It says, for her house inclineth unto death, and her paths unto the dead. None that go unto her return again, neither take they hold of the paths of life. All right. Seems kind of a strange verse that you picked there. Anyway, so continue on. It says the status curriculum is reinforced by modern media. The way of God, John 14, 6, is the way of life. Amen. The writer of Proverbs calls this the way of both wisdom and understanding. And it says, see Proverbs 3, 13 through 18. So let's go to Proverbs 3, 13 through 18. It says here in Proverbs 3, 18, or 13 through 18, it says, happy is the man that findeth wisdom, and the man that getteth understanding. For the merchandise of it is better than the merchandise of silver, and the gain thereof than fine silver. She is more precious than rubies, and all the things thou canst desire are not to be compared unto her. Length of days is in her right hand, and in her left hand riches and honor. Her ways are ways of pleasantness, and all her paths are peace. She is a tree of life to them that lay hold upon her, and happy is everyone that retaineth her. Amen. So that was Proverbs 3:13-18. All right, continuing on, he says, I call this operation saturation. He says, I base this on Deuteronomy 6:1-9. So let's go here and read Deuteronomy 6:1-9. Get the Bible here and get understanding of what he's trying to explain here. All right, so Deuteronomy 6:1-9. All right, it says here, 1-9 of Deuteronomy 6, it says, now these are the commandments, the statutes, and the judgments which the Lord your God commanded to teach you, that ye might do them in the land whither ye go to possess it, that thou mightest fear the Lord thy God to keep all his statutes and his commandments, which I command thee, thou and thy son and thy son's son, all the days of thy life, and that thy days may be prolonged. Hear therefore, O Israel, and observe to do it, that it may be well with thee, and that ye may increase mightily, as the Lord God of thy fathers hath promised thee, in the land that floweth with milk and honey. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thine heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy might. And these words which I command thee this day shall be in thine heart, and thou shalt teach them diligently unto thy children, and shalt talk of them when thou sittest in thine house, and when thou walkest by the way, and when thou liest down, and when thou risest up, and thou shalt bind them for a sign upon thine head, and they shall be as frontlets between thine eyes. And thou shalt write them upon the posts of thine house and on thy gates. So that was Deuteronomy. And of course, we know that's talking to the nation of Israel, but you can always apply that to your life. But we've got to make sure you understand that who that's being spoken to, and there's lots of things in the New Testament for born-again believers to obey and do, so better to go to the New Testament and find out what born-again believers, how they're supposed to live, amen, and some of those things are similar to the things given to Israel, but then there's some things that are just for us, and then there's some things that are just for them, so amen. All right, so moving on, it says, the saturation and its operation include parents and grandparents promoting identical teaching, a God-centered curriculum, amen. Their efforts are reinforced by a Christian educational system using a God-centered curriculum. The church offers more foundational support in the training of the child, reinforcing both the home and Christian school. He says, I call this the triangle of hope, and no one can train a child in the way he should go unless this triangle is implemented into the training process. He says, Proverbs 3:12 is an often used scripture to emphasize this triangle. A threefold cord is not quickly broken. The church, the home, and the school, all synchronized spiritually, are a powerful tool in this triangle of hope for the home. Well, amen. So praise the Lord. That's an interesting topic there on curriculum and how to train a child in the way they should go and make sure that they're going the way of the Lord and make sure that it all lines up together in this triangle here. Amen. All right, so that was the end of the topic, curriculum for today. All right, so making sure we're learning God's word, whether you're a child or an adult. Amen. All right, now it's time to get into today's hymn and hymn story. And so today's hymn is titled, let me get there. All right, put that there. Do this here. All right. All right, so today's hymn and hymn story is titled, Where Shall My Wandering Soul Begin? And this is another one by Charles Wesley. It says, Ater to Jeremiah Ingalls. Not sure what that ATTR stands for, what the initials are for that, but that was to Jeremiah Ingalls. All right, and looks like there's only two stanzas here. So let me read them to you. I'm not too familiar with this hymn, so I'll just read you these two stanzas. All right, it says, where shall my wandering soul begin? How shall I all to heaven aspire? A slave redeemed from death and sin, a brand plucked from eternal fire. How shall I equal triumphs? Raise or sing my great deliverer's praise. And then stanza 2 says, Come, O my guilty brethren, come, groaning beneath your load of sin. His bleeding heart shall make you room, his open side shall take you in. He calls you now, invites you home. Come, O my guilty brethren, come. All right, so that's the two stanzas there. Now I'll go ahead and get into the story. And this is titled again, Where Shall My Wandering Soul Begin? Written in 1739. And the passage is from Psalm 39, verse 7. So I've got my Bible here and go to Psalm 39, 7. All right, so Psalm 39, 7. Let's get here. So Psalm 39, 7. It says here in verse 7, it says, And now, Lord, what wait I for? My hope is in thee. Amen. So it says, And now, Lord, what wait I for? My hope is in thee. Amen. So our hope should always be in the Lord. All right, so go ahead and press play here and Alright, here we go. This is the story here behind the hymn, Where Shall My Wandering Soul Begin? And this says here, the great hymnist, Charles Wesley was converted to Christ on Pentecost, Sunday, May 21st, 1738. He was staying in the London home of his friend, John Bray. He was ill at the time, and Bray was tending to him both physically and spiritually. Wesley's journal tracks the course of his remarkable conversion. So this is his journal. It says, Thursday, May 11, 1738. Mr. Bray read me many comfortable scriptures, so that I was persuaded I should not leave his house before I believed with my heart unto righteousness. May 12. This day I spent in discouraging on faith, either with those that had it or those that sought it. May 13. I walked without Christ, yet still desirous of finding him. May 14. The beginning of the day, I was very heavy, weary, and unable to pray. I longed to find Christ, that I might show him to all mankind. May 17. About midnight, I was waked by the return of my pleasure. I felt great pain and straitness at my heart, but found immediate relief by bleeding. I had some discourse with Mr. Bray, thought myself willing to die the next moment, if I might but believe. May 19. At 5 this morning, the pain and difficulty in breathing returned. The surgeon was sent for, but I fell asleep before he could bleed me a second time. I was easier all day. He says, I was easier all day after taking Dr. Cockburn's medicines. I received the sacrament, but not Christ. May 20. I waked much disappointed and continued all day in great dejection. Mr. Bray, too, seemed troubled at my not yet believing. Sunday, May 21st, 1738. I rose and looked into the scripture. The words that first presented were, And now, Lord, what is my hope? Truly, my hope is even in thee. I now find myself at peace with God, and rejoiced in hope of loving Christ. I saw that by faith I stood. I went to bed, confident of Christ's protection. Within just a day or two, Charles wrote, Where shall my wandering soul begin? Some historians believe it is the first of his thousands of hymns, one that expressed the joy of his newfound birth, or newfound faith. Well, amen. All right, so that was the end of the story there. And this was leading up to his conversion and him trusting the Lord as Savior. Amen. So, praise the Lord. All right, so that is the end of the hymn and hymn story. Where shall my wandering soul begin? And tomorrow's hymn and hymn story will be from the hymn, Oh, for a Heart to Praise My God, another one by Charles Wesley. It says this is a collection of hymns and sacred poems, probably arranged by John F. Lampe. There's an E on the end there, so I'm not sure if the E is silent or if you're supposed to say Lampe or Lamp. So that'll be tomorrow's hymn and hymn story, and this was written in 1742. And the passage will be from 2 Timothy 3:15. Amen. So that'll be tomorrow's hymn and hymn story. All right. So we'll go ahead and sing some scripture songs to wrap it up. Amen. All right. So we'll go ahead and sing yesterday's, and then we'll conclude with today's. So yesterday was from the 21st. All right. Here we go.
Acts 20:35.
I have showed you all things, how that so laboring ye ought to support the weak, and to remember the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said, It is more blessed to give than to receive. Amen. I have showed you all things, how that so laboring ye ought to support the weak. I have showed you all things, how they're so laboring. Ye ought to support the weak, and to remember the words of the Lord Jesus. And to remember the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. It is more blessed to give than to receive. It is more blessed to give. I have showed you all things, how that's so laboring. Ye ought to support the weak. I have showed you all things, how the soul laboring, ye ought to support the weak, and to remember the words of the Lord Jesus, and to remember the words of the Lord Jesus, how he said, it is more blessed to give than to receive. It is more blessed to give than to receive. It is more blessed to give. Amen. All right, now let's go ahead and sing today's one more time.
Psalms 43:3-4.
Oh, send out thy light and thy truth. Let them lead me. Let them bring me unto thy holy hill and to thy tabernacles. Then will I go unto the altar of God, unto God my exceeding joy. Yea, upon the harp will I praise thee, O God, my God. Amen. All right, here we go. Send out thy light and thy truth. Let them lead me, let them lead me unto thy holy hill and to thy tabernacles. Then will I go unto the altar of God, unto God my exceeding joy. Yea, upon the harp will I praise thee, O God, my God. Send out thy light and thy truth. Let them lead me, let them bring me unto thy holy hill and to thy tabernacles. Then will I go unto the altar of God, unto God my exceeding joy. Yea, upon the harp will I praise thee, O God, my God. Upon the harp will I praise thee, O God, my God. Amen. All right, well, that'll be it for today's broadcast. But as always, before I go, let me give you tomorrow's scripture song and then tomorrow's Baptist Bread devotional topic. So tomorrow will be the 23rd, and we'll be singing Revelation 19:16. And he hath on his vesture and on his thigh a name written, King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Amen and hallelujah. All right, so that'll be tomorrow's scripture song. And then tomorrow's topic will be titled, let's see here, where are we at? So tomorrow is the 23rd, so tomorrow's topic is titled Cartwheels, Fitches, and Coming. So that sounds like another interesting topic. Cartwheels, Fitches, and Coming. So the passage is Isaiah 28:27. Amen. So we'll find out more about that tomorrow. And if you'd like to get a box of these devotionals, they're available on the website here at www.timgreenministries.org. And that's how you can get those. And they're $12.95, and you get a subscription of those, and they send them to you every other month. And so you'll probably get next month's, which will be November and December. And then the scripture songs, they're available. The CDs are available on the website at www.dailyscripturesongs.com. Amen. And then the book here, Then Sings My Soul, Book 2, 150 of the World's Greatest Hymn Stories, written by Robert J. Morgan. And then tomorrow's hymn story title is Oh for a Heart to Praise My God, another one by Charles Wesley. Amen. And so let's see how many we got here. We got a bunch of them coming up here by Charles Wesley. So about four more of these written by Charles Wesley. Amen. So that'll be tomorrow's. All right. So that'll be it for today. So thanks for watching, and may the Lord richly bless you until next time. All right. Bye for now.